So good morning, everybody. Visual fields is still the most commonly used estimation of functional visual loss. And despite the advent of OCT and other machines which are going to give you structural loss, there is nothing as of now to replace visual fields. So they will continue to remain the mainstay of one of the pillars of glaucoma management. But two, three things I want to tell you, which tests. So you should use only threshold tests to look for glaucomatous defects. And now with the advent of, earlier there was a complaint that these threshold tests take a long time. But with the advent of shorter tests, even in 5 minutes, 6 minutes, you can have a very good reliable visual field. So that's no longer an excuse. We can use the 24-2 or 30 degrees fields in whichever perimeter you have. If there are tubular fields or paracentral points are involved, then you should go ahead and do a 10 degrees. Now, any field when I see, I ask that field, is it reliable? Is it normal? If it is abnormal, is it an artifact or is it a true defect? Does it have a recognizable pattern? And more importantly, in glaucoma, does it correlate with the disc and field, and is it repeatable? If you ask every field these six questions, then most of the times you are able to identify a defect and also tell you what this defect signifies. So first is, the first question, is it reliable? So one is fixation losses. Earlier we were told 20% fixation loss, 33% false positive, false negative, but it no longer holds true. At 20%, in fact, false positives can affect your field at percentages far less than even 20%. So 20, 20, 20, and the machine will flag it for you. In this particular field, it's perfect. Fixation losses are zero, no false positives, and so this is an ideal field. But now, for example, if you get a high fixation loss, 13 on 14, almost 100%, that does not mean it's an unreliable field. Look at false positives, they're very good. False negatives are excellent. Here, when a person, if you have done a field yourself, you'll realize that the first thing the machine does is it tries to chart the blind spot. If the patient is inattentive that time, the blind spot, which should have been here 15 degrees, is plotted in a different way. And so every time now, the real blind spot is ignored, and this is one condition when there is a faulty blind spot spotting, you will get 100% fixation losses, but this field is perfectly reliable. But however, now look here, 6 by 17, again, the blind spot has been not plotted properly, but if you see, the false positives are just 2%. Now, if you realize the faster machines, they are fast because they compromise on certain things. They don't actually check. They extrapolate and calculate and assume certain things. So it is assumed that false positive is just 2%. But if you see a large white scotoma here. If you see, the sensitivities are 49, 44, which are far too high. So be careful when you're using faster thresholds that they assume things, and sometimes they are wrong. So, and the only thing which tells you that this is a completely unreliable field is that this is a white scotoma here, and the glaucoma hemifield test is telling you abnormally high sensitivity. So this is one more thing. This is completely unreliable. This was why I was not going to talk so much on reliability, but just last week this patient was referred to me because you can't read from here, but the false positive is 23% and false negative is 33%. But because of this scotoma, the referring doctor thought the person is worsening on fields, and you should still trust this field, but believe me, if it's unreliable, it is unreliable, please repeat it. So this is the only reason why I spoke so much on reliability. You should not take into consideration an unreliable field. Now we come to the second question. Is it normal or is it abnormal? I have seen that it is reliable. Total deviation is normal. Pattern deviation is normal. I am convinced that it is a normal field. But now sometimes we see fields which are like these, which show very stray and not very deep scotomas. So is this defect significant? For that we have Anderson's criteria, which has all these three. It is just a guideline. It's not mandatory. If you have clinical correlation and if it does not fulfill all these criteria, even then the field still may give you some information. So Anderson's criteria are guidelines. Now this is again a field, I'm asking the same question, is it reliable? Yes, it is. Now is it abnormal or normal? It is abnormal in the sense the total deviation shows generalized depression, but the pattern deviation is normal. So there is some abnormality, but it is not glaucoma. Having come to this, how does a glaucomatous field look? It has all these appearances. But the most common thing is it will be an arcuate scotoma with a broad nasal base and tapering at the end, and the sensitivity of the base is worse than the sensitivity at the tail. So this is the most common way you see. The second thing is a double arcuate scotoma, which is another finding, but many times the double arcuate may be here it looks equal, but when you actually see the sensitivity, the inferior arcuate scotoma is much worse than the superior arcuate scotoma. I have seen in advanced field defects, the temporal lobe here, there are only 4 points which have some degree of sensitivity, but even in that, the temporal field is preserved more than the nasal field. This is one hallmark of advanced field defects, of glaucoma field defects. This is a 10-2, if you see, only the far temporal. So temporal being preserved more than nasal is one of the ways of identifying glaucoma defect in a very advanced field. Second thing, there was this patient who was on treatment from 2010 to 2016 because of this field, and she was labeled as glaucoma. She came to me in 2016, and believe me, it is reliable, it is abnormal. Is it repeatable? Yes, the abnormality is repeatable, but is it correlating with the disc? When I asked that question, no, this is the disc. And believe me, it was non-progressive, so this is a true visual field defect, but it is not glaucomatous. So this is one way how you differentiate. Second thing is, now this is an early glaucomatous field superior, and it corresponds to the very early thinning in the inferior part. This is a glaucomatous defect. One more. There is a thinning here and an inferior field defect, it is glaucomatous. So all I wanted to tell you is that a field defect is glaucomatous only and only if it correlates with the disc. Unreliable fields are unreliable. Even in advanced field damage, temporal fields are preserved more than nasal. Artifacts are shapeshifters, they can take any shape, any form. And when you are in doubt, repeat, glaucoma is one disease which gives you time to think. You don't have to say now and here. So when in doubt, you can always repeat. And thank you for a very, very patient hearing.